Ezekiel was given a prophecy for a period of time at the end of this era of time where the dead bodies will be buried. This prophecy is recorded in Ezekiel chapter 39, and it will come to pass in that day that I will give unto Gog a place there of graves in Israel in the valley east of the sea, and it will stop the noses of the passerby when they pass, and Gog and all of his multitude will be buried there, and it will be called the Valley of Hamon Gog. The house of Israel will bury them for 7 months in order to cleanse the land. All of the people of the land will bury them, and doing so will name the day that I will be glorified, saith Adonai Yehweh. He is saying that revealing this period of time that the dead are going to be buried is naming the day that he will be glorified. Yehweh's word is extremely dynamic in bearing witness to itself in the manner that it does. Understanding when this period of time will be is simply a matter of waiting on his time to reveal how and where it fits into his word. In the last video, I spoke that there will be a period of time when the sacrifices will be reinstated for those who will be delivered into the millennium who have trampled his only begotten son's shed blood under their feet. Ezekiel also recorded when the sanctuary will be cleansed. This is found in Ezekiel chapter 45. Thus saith Adonai Yehweh, in the first month, on the first day of the month, you shall take a young bullock without blemish and cleanse the sanctuary. And the priest shall take the blood of the sin offering and put it upon the post of the house and upon the four corners of the altar settle and upon the post of the gate of the inner court. The first order of business after the great and fearful day of his wrath will be burying the dead. Then after the dead are buried, the sanctuary will be cleansed. The reference to 7 months is both a reference to a specific period of 7 months as well as a prophecy for 7 weeks. This particular 7 month period will funnel into 7 weeks that will follow the great and fearful day of Yehweh's wrath. It is spectacular how there is a perfect match of 7 weeks that is found from the day of his wrath until the first day of the first month in his restored calendar. The end of the day of his wrath will be on the 8th day of the 11th month. This will be on January 20th on Satan's calendar. The following Sabbath will be on the 15th day of the 11th month, ending week 1. Then the 22nd day will end the second week, and the 29th day will end the third week, followed by the two new month assembly days. Then the 8th day of the 12th month will end the fourth week. The 15th day will end the fifth week. The 22nd day will end the 6th week, and the 29th day will end the 7th week. Then the second new month assembly day that follows the 7th Sabbath will be the first day of the first month. This is when the sanctuary is going to be cleansed, and the sacrifices will be offered up at this time. The tier of 7 actual months that will funnel into this 7-week period of burying the dead also ends on the first day of the first month. It is found in one of the Zerubbabel Yeshua prophecies recorded in Haggai chapter 1. In the second year of King Darius, in the 6th month, on the first day of the month, Yehweh's word came through Haggai the prophet unto Zerubbabel, the son of Shealtiel, governor of Judah, and to Yeshua, the son of Josedech, the high priest, saying, thus saith Yehweh of hosts, saying, this people say that the time that Yehweh's house will be built, that the time has not come. In just a few weeks will be the first day of the 6th month on Yehweh's restored calendar. The first day of the 6th month is exactly 7 months from the first day of the first month next year. There are no other 7-month prophecies that end on the first day of the first month found in Yehweh's word. And like I said, it is simply spectacular that there are exactly 7 weeks between January 20th and the first day of the first month that follows it. As far as what he is saying through Haggai here in verse 2 about the people saying that it is not time for his house to be built, most of you believe a variety of different false beliefs that keep you from seeing that the time is at hand. You are still waiting for your two witnesses to show up on the scene or for this or for that to happen? Well, you are soon going to find out differently. Like I said in the video that I posted earlier today is the last day of my walking naked and barefoot. And it begins the final 6-month showdown that will funnel into January 20th. In this prophecy, Yehweh goes on to say that he is with Zerubbabel and Yeshua, who are his two witnesses, and with those standing with them. Like I said in the last video, I do not know how these final 6 months will unfold. I just know that what I have spoken will come to pass in them. And His Word says that you are going to know that He has sent me to you. His Word testifies that most of His wrath will be in the final day and hour, which He has already declared to be the 7 days that lead up to January 20th. Things that I have spoken, like Yellowstone blowing and the West Coast tsunami and the plagues and pestilences, will come to pass. And I am confident that you will see many more exacting judgments come out from my mouth that will come to pass in these 6 months. The first day of the sixth month will be in 23 days, and it lands on the 15th day of August on Satan's calendar. I have not spoken much about how he is woven the number 23 into his timeline, because most of it has been a personal stamp to me. But I have spoken about some of the references, like the 2300 morning and evening sacrifices of Daniel's prophecy. Here's another 23 stamp, the number of the Levites that Moses numbered at the time that the children of Israel crossed over the Jordan to possess the land that flowed with milk and honey was 23,000. On this first day of the sixth month, we will be 157 days out from January 20th. Do you think that it is yet another coincidence that it was also 157 days from when Noah was told to start loading the ark until YEHWEH recorded that he remembered him? If you do, you are indeed stiff-necked, and you are risen up above that which YEHWEH's word has testified to. And His wrath is about to be unleashed upon you, to either humble you into repentance or to purge you from before His face if you will not repent. The time of His wrath is near at hand. If you think that it is not, or if you think that you are in tight with Him without standing with His two anointed sons in this final showdown, His word says differently. Prepare to be humbled. Thus saith YEHWEH Elohim.